Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a flip through of my fourth sketchbook. So let's get into the video. This first drawing I had done was a redraw of something I had done last year. And I enjoyed doing this. There was a couple of flaws, obviously, that always happens with my art, but I quite enjoyed doing this. This is also on YouTube if you do care to check out why I did this and everything like that. This was me just drawing 12 different landscapes because I felt like more pulled to do landscapes in this sketchbook. And again, there's a video on this. Again, I was feeling more drawn towards doing landscapes, but I also did want to draw some characters, so I did this. I don't actually know what this is supposed to be. It's rather strange, not really planned out, not my usual thing. These are just some eyes because I wanted to do something which is quite simple and easy to do. These were some guinea pigs that I drew because guinea pigs are adorable. I love guinea pigs so much. This was a 1860s inspired illustration, and this was an illustration based off of a quote by Louisa May Alcott in her Little Women book about castles in the sky. So I was drawing some clouds and I just literally put a castle in the sky. I did post that on Instagram as well. These were some drawings that I'm not particularly proud of. They're supposed to be a Bernadette Banner, and they don't look like Bernadette Banner. They just look kind of weird, so we're gonna pretend that didn't happen. And this was just a drawing of a pond, and which is also wonky. I can't seem to draw a normal shape. This was a pink sea with a little island and a boat. I had originally just done the sea and then thought it didn't look very finished, so I added in some things after as an afterthought, so you can kind of tell it's not done very well, but oh well. These are some sketches that I had coloured in parts of it but left most of it white. More sketches. This was an 1870s inspired illustration. I was watching one of Myra Byler. I honestly don't know how to say her name, sorry. And she had done some ideas of how to fill in your sketchbook, and I had followed one of those, and I really like the border thing, so I did it again with a Edwardian painting thing. I actually quite like this one, it's kind of cute, except for where the tape let the watercolour flow. This was supposed to be Amy Lee. I'm embarrassed about it as well, it doesn't look great, so we're gonna ignore that. These are some sketches that I just coloured over. This was a fun little painting I had done of sea, obviously, and like I think it had been like dawn or something. Yeah, I don't remember if I had any reference. I might have just made it all up. This was just another painting, which I found the reference photo on Pinterest. This was a drawing of one of my OCs, Lily, and I really like the fluffy dress. I don't want to show this page on camera because I don't like it, so we're gonna skip it. These are just some doodles of some flowers, which I then covered over with a blue acrylic, and you can tell where I didn't smooth out properly. This was a sketch for an acrylic painting I still have to start, but I like the idea, and I clearly start becoming very obsessed with swans over the next few pages because I just can't seem to stop drawing them. This was a Regency era inspired thing. It's definitely not exactly historically accurate, but it was fun to do. More sketches covered in acrylic paint. Some sketches covered in watercolor paint. A painting of the sky with a moon and clouds, because this is where my mind strays to. I love like dreaming and just staying in my head a lot. And a lot of people say that my head is always up in the clouds, so clouds. That one's not right. I did this drawing of like a kind of nymph in the water, and yeah, that's okay. Sorry, I'll move this. This was supposed to be a storm, kind of lightning things. I don't really like it that much. This seems to be a theme. I don't like a lot of these paintings. It's my sketchbook, to be honest. It doesn't really matter. And this was a girl kind of falling or drowning into the water. I like doing this quite a lot. It's fun to do. This was kind of supposed to be the similar thing. I never ended up finishing it because I didn't like the way it was going. This was a little painting of another island in the middle of the sea. Same thing happened as the last one. I drawn the sea in, didn't think enough was going on, so I tried to add things in after, and you can tell it's just an afterthought. This was just, and again, sea, clouds, very stormy day. This was inspired, I was watching one of Drawing with Waffles videos, and she was drawing animals, and I tried to do a couple that she did, and yeah, this was fun to do. This is upside down actually. This was a cloud. I have nothing else to say about it. It's okay. This is another Regency era inspired illustration with no background, which was something I was trying to work on in this sketchbook, but there are sometimes I just couldn't be bothered apparently. But this is kind of an evening gown, not exactly historically accurate. But it was fun to do. This was 1970s inspired because or 1980s. I think 1970s, 1980s. We were watching like a documentary about that time era on TV, and I was just going along. It was fun to do. Also, I really like 1970s fashion. this was like, I believe we were watching Dancing on Ice, and the next day I decided to do this painting for. Drawing, it was done in pencil, not painting, of this girl skating. I didn't do a great job with the foreshortening, but it's okay. Some sketches of some ballerinas, an eye, because eyes are cool. Valentine's inspired illustration, 1950s, 1960s illustration. Because I like that time era as well for fashion and stuff. This was me planning my drawing on floor tiles video. This is also in that video. Some historically inspired fashion, except for this one. That one's completely modern. No inspiring. I don't know. This was just like a page of just me doodling, and this was fun to do. And I kind of like the way it looks, so that's good. This was another little fantasy kind of inspired thing. I don't really like this one, but I like the idea of it. This was supposed to be a painting of an angel jumping off the moon, because I was reading the book Torment, and I thought it would look really cool if this angel was like, jumping off the moon. But I don't like it that much. It's looking a lot better in my head. These are some fantasy landscapes that I made a video on YouTube. And some more sketches done in watercolour. This was a still life I did without anything in front of me. I completely made that scene up. This was a still life I did for school, and I actually did have things in between for that. I apparently did this upside down. I am also very happy with how the background turned out in this. Does not normally go as well as I hope it does. I don't like the dress though. This was a random idea I had when I was walking with a friend, but I decided to draw some coastal houses on clouds. Why not? This was another watercolour illustration I did, giving some tips on how to improve your watercolour drawings, inspired by the 1850s. And this was an illustration by my characters, which I did not think looks like my characters. I try. And this is the last drawing I did in my sketchbook. This is supposed to be inspired by The Show Must Go On.
It's sort of an illustration of the lyrics, literally trying to draw out the kind of lyrics. Not all of them, but some of them. So this was the first sketchbook I did this year, and I think I have accomplished some of the goals I set for myself. Not all of them, and I forgot about some of them while doing this, but I really enjoyed doing this sketchbook. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys next week. Goodbye! Bye.